Oh, ah, you're watching Heavy Betting All Stars. My name is Paris Tomar. I'm with Eijaz Khan and this is brilliant because can you smell it? It's like the beautiful smell of fresh air.
Yes, it is.
I like the fact that you got us to the doggy playground.
Yeah, this is where we hang out most of the time when I have free time. These are free most of the time otherwise.
Which is incredible. So, you know, you have to spend 5 minutes with the man to know that he really obviously loves his dogs very much. They're also the kind of pets who don't go to anyone else. Okay, so this is not me taking it personally, but they're like, you know, if Eijaz is in the house, they just want to go to him. How does that happen?
These guys have a pack mentality and I am the alpha dog here.
So they have to follow my lead most of the time.
Can you just say that?
Yeah.
To my face?
Yeah.
It's like, bro, you can go chill out. Like, bro, you're like,
okay, between the three of us. This guy keeps challenging me all the time. So if I'm sitting on a higher perch, he'll come and sit next to me to challenge that all the time. So I have to keep telling him, okay, I love you too. But you can't take me for a walk, I have to take you for a walk.
It's like a one-upmanship thingy. So like obviously that's something which requires a lot of you sort of thinking about it or getting trained yourself, I'm assuming.
Yeah. Luckily, Shweta Salve, quite a friend of mine.
She's been on heavy petting.
Yeah. She had Dino, I remember. So she shared her secret with me, that was Tony, who's an excellent trainer. He actually trains rock fighters. So one day he came home and he said, okay, before I start training them, I have to train you how to handle the dog, how to understand the dog. If the dog is barking, it's more of an argument. If the dog is pushing his head against a wall, that's a nervous disorder. So I came to know all these things. Like for instance, this guy, he's got his head against my thigh. He's nervous right now because of all these people surrounding him. He's got a little bit of a nervous disorder, ADHD.
So let's put him out of his nervousness. How do we make friends with him? He said, we like you, bro.
Like, yeah, because of you.
How do you make friends with him?
I just spend time with him.
Yeah?
Yeah, he likes attention and he likes playing with a ball, as you can see.
Yeah.
He's obsessed with his toys.
Check it, I got the doggy currency. you like me now, don't you? I've noticed that's the one thing which is a great way to win the heart of any dog. He's like, your eyes are getting heavier. Look, it's like I can hypnotize you.
Okay, better throw it, he's gonna feel bad otherwise.
He's gonna be like, bro, what are you doing? Check him. He's incredible. 7-year-old Labrador brothers Max and Raya are the perfect companions for Eijaz. While Max is the one who gets all the female attention and loves to cuddle, Raya is the more emotional and sensitive of the two. The bromance that the three of them share is certainly evident. So, when you're... I'm assuming you shoot a lot, alright?
Yeah, almost every day.
How are you spending time with the doggies then?
Well, my morning tea is with them. I read the newspaper with them, I go down.
Do they like it with milk or without milk? How much sugar?
They don't like this thing. They get fruits in the morning. They get bananas and watermelon. Muskmelon, they love it.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. And I take them down in the compound where I'm having my tea, I'm sitting with them, I'm playing with them. And at night when I come back, I make it a point to take them for a long walk.
Through the day, you know, this is one of those things that I keep reading. It was actually beautiful where somebody said when you come home, you have to make sure that you have to understand that the dog loves you because while you're away, it's not like the dog is thinking, let me go read that novel. They're waiting for you the whole day, right? Yeah. So when you get home, what's the first thing you do with them?
You get a hero's welcome. I mean, whatever, however kind of a day you've had, however bad it was, as soon as they come at the door, they hug you and they're licking you and they're so happy, they're squealing with delight when you're back home. It just makes everything worth it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How did you get them?
I got them from a friend of mine. He had somebody with a litter. So these two boys came home. I was supposed to choose one of them, but I couldn't let go of any. So both, they're brothers. Yeah, stayed with me.
Okay, what's favorite meal? You said muskmelon, they like watermelon. What's the one thing they will jump with joy for?
I think the little treats that they get. Yeah. So if I want to train them, so instead of screaming at them or instead of the kind of police training that goes, which is hitting them with a newspaper or something, I've never done that. It's always been bribing them with treats. So if I call them, they come, they sit. I make sure that they get a treat. So yeah, that's what they like.
It's wrong to talk about treats and not give them some. I'm pretty sure like we're always handy. That's the part that I love about this show. It's like, OMGG, we got like awesome food for you, bro.
Max, come here.
So much happiness is happening. There you go. Oh, check it. Oh, the doggies are like so happy. Fit for royalty, I want you to notice this, okay? I put the food down, they were like, we're not really gonna eat it unless you feed us. So it's like really cool, I like it. Like, bro, feed it to us, it's really cool. What's the one thing that they love doing at home if you catch them sometimes when they're alone? They're just by themselves, unsupervised, don't know they're being watched. What are you likely to catch them doing?
They like snuggling and sleeping all the time. Because they've grown up with each other. So sometimes when we are not there, when they're feeling alone, they're snuggling by themselves and rubbing each other and going to sleep and actually putting each other to sleep. Okay. But when I'm at home, so they come to me.
They come to me. Who's the biggest cuddle monkey between the
three
of you?
This
one, Max. You win it hands down. Yeah. I like it. Now, if you want to ever learn the trick of voice modulation, that's the man you need to speak to. Right? Because when you spend about 5 minutes, you suddenly realize he talks to like the dogs and other people in these various different kinds of like, you know, he goes like all deep suddenly. What's the story there?
So what I learned was, dogs don't really understand words.
Sure.
They realize the tone. So if it is Max and I need to make him happy, it's going to be in a higher tone. Hi, Max. Hi, baby. How are you, baby? Hi, Raya. And if I want to order them, it's going to be Max, sit. Sit. Okay, he's not interested right now.
He's basically thinking you're confusing me. There was love 1 second ago. Make up your mind.
But you see this guy, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Good boy. So when you need to be the alpha dog, you speak in a deep-throated voice, or when you need to give a command, and when you need to release it, you speak in a higher tone. So that's what they
understand. If you want him to like get up, then what will you say? Like,
Max, up, boy, come here, good boy. Good boy.
Isn't that incredible? That is so cute. His dogs are also really fashionable. Let's take a moment. Check that out. I have never seen anyone with like really cool radical footwear. What's going on there? What's in the purple socks?
So, during monsoon especially over here, they come to the dog park, they get fleas sometimes, or there is general dirt and filth lying around. So these are paws, they're called paws. These are rubber silicone socks that they wear, and when they enter the house, these are removed so the house is not dirty, and nor do they get any infection between their webs, which they tend to get sometimes in monsoon.
Especially in monsoon.
Yeah.